A deadly weekend in Albuquerque, a murder-suicide and a double murder, plus there is a third victim from that case still recovering from gunshot wounds.
And that's where we find Action 7 News reporter Liz McKernan with new details on both of these cases.
Well, Doug and Shelley, right now that man is in stable condition. He's expected to recover. The only person to survive a weekend that's added in the tragic loss of four lives.
It started with gunfire early Saturday morning when investigators find two women, one dead, the other barely alive, at this apartment complex near Lomas in Louisiana. That second victim died at the hospital, another showing up a short time later looking for treatment for his gunshot wounds. A short 12 hours later, police get another call, this time from a man who went to check on his ailing aunt and uncle, who weren't answering the phone at their mobile home near Louisiana in San Antonio.
Neighbors tell us that witness walked into the mobile home only to find his aunt and uncle on the ground. And he says that it looked as if the uncle fired the first shot, then turned the gun on himself. Police sources confirming that story to us.
I don't know what was going through his mind at that point, you know. If he would have wanted to talk, I could have talked to him.
Neighbors say Kenneth and Shelley Robson inherited their parents' home. Kenneth, in his early 70s, took care of Shelley in her late 60s, who required kidney dialysis twice a week. It's not clear exactly what led to the bloodshed. Police telling us there wasn't a note or anything left behind to explain why.
You always hear this across town or something, but you don't hear it about it right next door.
A deadly end to a weekend that's left at least two families without their loved ones.
Well, right now, police have still not released the names of the two women killed in that early Saturday morning shooting. They're telling us, however, that they are still hunting down leads, trying to find anybody who might know some information about that murder case. Reporting live in Northeast Albuquerque, Liz McKernan, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Police say forensic investigators are working to piece together both murder scenes to find out exactly what happened.